Hello everybody, my name is Eugenia. I'm the curriculum coordinator for the Transformational Breath Foundation. And I am saying hi to you today from the New York area. And I am going to pass it along to the rest of the staff. So we also have with us here today, Abe, if you want to introduce yourself.
Most definitely. Thank you, Eugenia. Welcome, everybody. So nice to see all the familiar faces. Just loving everyone continuing to deepen their relationship with their breath and continue this lifelong practice. Just very grateful and happy to be here. Again, my name is Abraham. I live in San Diego. I am also currently in New York. Happy to be here as well. I think that's all I have to share. I will be co-leading the breakout room with this lovely being I'd like to pass it to.
Hi, everyone. My name is Siobhan O'Sullivan, and I live in beautiful Calgary, Alberta, Canada. I'm so grateful to be a part of this today and see all of your beautiful faces. I would like to take a special moment to say a very happy birthday to my beautiful friend, Gary. Happy birthday. And I'm happy to be here also in the New York area today. Thank you.
Thank you, Siobhan. So, and I would like to invite our beautiful leader in transformational breath, the founder of this technique, and a mother, a spiritual mother to many of us here in this call, our beautiful Judith Kravitz.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Wow, beautiful beings of love and light. I want to welcome you all to our February family gathering. And I wanted to call it Leaps of Love for a number of reasons. And it's a very special day. Last month, we were there on the full moon. And here we are on the winter's full moon without even planning it. But the universe is just here to support us in our coming together and also in our breathing. So I'm really excited about our theme for today, self-love, because it's very much represents a path that I've been journeying on, and probably all of us have. You know, February is known as the month to celebrate love, personal love, expanded love. And we just honored a big global holiday all about love, Valentine's Day, where millions of people around the world celebrated love in one form or another. Today, we want to celebrate all of you, supporting you in expanding, loving yourself fully, and having a deeper well of love to share with others. And this came to me, and it's been seeping in on a gradual basis, that it's actually impossible to give or receive love if we don't love ourselves. And I'll say it again, it's impossible to give or receive love if we don't love ourselves. And this was something I did not always understand. And I experienced the effects of that for many years in my life, not knowing why my love for another was not being returned or why I didn't feel or accept someone's love. At one point, I just began to make the connection between the energetic resonance of love being given to our capacity to be able to receive love. I also started noticing the levels of self-love and appreciation that seemed to either exist or not exist within me and others. I could see that demonstrated most clearly in relationships with some of my children, deeply feeling my love for them and yet seeing how some were just not able to accept or experience love in their lives. I saw that connection and I realized the missing piece was true self-love, love for myself and love for them. Self-love, however, can be a mysterious journey. When I started exploring it, I began asking, how can I love myself? It actually seemed foreign. I first believed if I did enough good things, I would be worthy and I could love myself. So that led me to a place where at the end of a day of, say, a good achievement day, I would hear inside, well done, and then a sense of love and appreciation would fill me. And this was nice, and yet it seemed conditional, that I had to do good and I had to be good to feel self-love. So then the next stage that I've been realizing and moving towards is the ultimate realization that I am love. And at my highest frequency, my highest identity, and my deepest core, I am unconditional, unlimited love. And we are all that love. It exists already. Nothing else is needed. It just is. I needed to have that realization to begin the journey, the true path to self-love. It sounds simple, right? I'm love. That's it. However, for most of us, it's a huge lifetime journey to reach that place inside and be able to live from there. I call it Earth School 1001. Yet for me, the first step, and for all of us, is the realization that this is our essential nature, unconditional love, that there's nothing to do, to accomplish, or become to create that reality. It is already so. So I want to just ask you, can we take a deep breath together and join in that awareness? So let's take a nice deep breath. We are already unconditional love. And breathe that in, that awareness in. I am already unconditional love. Our biggest job now, let it sink in for a second. Our biggest job now is to somehow remember, and that's a big remembrance. Then once consciously remembered, how do we connect or access that part of us? How can we get there? How do we experience that part of us? In transformational breath, there's a process, a stated intention, a pathway that takes us on the journey to connect with the frequency of love, the essence of what we are. This process is to go through the layers of beliefs and feelings that have provided a block or a barrier to that sacred inner space. So, and that sacred inner space is our highest vibrational state, love. How many of you have ever had an experience of that feeling inside of you, that you are love? I could like to see some hands. That everything is love, that you're not having any thoughts or past of the past or future, just here in that moment, feeling the grace of our essence as love. I know we've all had at least a glimmer of that. Or maybe you've even had that love reflected back to you from another in your life. How many of you had that experience? Raise your hands, let me know. Okay. We've all had a taste of that love, and some of you, many tastes, and it's a big part of why we are here, to remember and experience that love, the love that we are. I've known for a while that the breath can be a pathway to that place of presence and love inside of us. In transformational breath, we work consciously and effectively with the energetic movement on that pathway. We move through the vibrational layers of the physical, mental, and emotional to reach our spiritual nature. First of all, we begin by learning to use our full respiratory system, which brings us fully into our bodies, grounds us, and allows us, and actually allows our life force to flow fully and freely and completely through our body and our energy field, thus also creating a balance on every level. We emphasize this in all our breathing sessions. So for the new folks, this is where we begin, opening our respiratory system to bring our life force fully into our physical form. And this is where we begin our breath journey back to source. Then we use the energy of our connected breath to help us move through the blockages in our mental and emotional bodies. These blockages have acted as barriers to our higher awareness and self. And by integrating the repressions of the past, enables us to access, experience, feel, and express our spiritual nature. So today in our session, we're going to focus on supporting you to create, first of all, an open flowing breath and to anchor your life force strongly in your body. Then we're going to begin an inner journey, accessing and integrating the beliefs and feelings that have kept you stuck in the duality and conditional love. So what I want to do now is lead you in a short exercise to prepare our minds and emotions for that integration, for the integration of the unconscious pieces that have been blocking the flow of our connection to who we really are. We will begin to address what's called our unconscious definitions of love, because we have conscious ones, but we also have unconscious ones that have been creating our experiences of love. And these have been imprinted in us in our very early years. So we can begin to look at and open that space and work with what needs to transform on the mental and emotional levels. How does that sound? Would you like to do that with me? I hope so, because that's why we're here. All right.
Lots of thumbs up and smiley faces, Judy.
All right. Thank you. So now I just want to invite you. I don't want you to lay down, but I want you to sit in a comfortable way. And we're going to take a few slow, deep breaths to kind of get into a meditative space to do this exercise. So I'm going to invite everyone to just go ahead and breathe in slowly through your nose to the count of 5, 3, 4, 5. And I want you to hold that breath to 5, 3, 4, 5. And then exhale gently. Count of 5. And we're going to pause. Inhaling again, counting in your mind as the breath goes in slowly and deeply, holding, exhaling and really relaxing. Inhaling again, pausing. Exhaling, and pausing. All right, now, first we're going to put our attention on our mind and our beliefs. I want to ask us to look at any limiting or fearful thoughts we may have about love. You could ask inside, what do I believe about love that might be holding me back? What has shown up in my experience reflecting that belief? And just breathe into that inquiry and just see what comes up. Just notice what surfaces without any judgments. Just observe. What do I believe about love, and what has shown up to demonstrate that belief? Another nice deep breath. And now you can ask, what is a new belief I can have about me and love? Maybe it's, I'm worthy, I'm lovable, I believe in love, there is hope for me. I am love. Those are just some of them, but just find a word, be with those thoughts and see how they feel. I'm worthy. I'm lovable. I believe in love. There is hope for me. I am love. And I'm going to ask you to pick one of those that could be the focus for your mind in your session today. And moving on, we're going to look at our feelings about love, the resonance. How do we feel about the experiences of love that you've had in your life? Quite a shocker it was for me. Have they been joyful and happy? Did you feel loved and accepted? And the big question is, how did they end? And what did you feel at the end of a relationship, either romantic or friendship? What did you feel at the end of that? That feeling is a good indication of your unconscious beliefs about love. We know the conscious ones, but those unconscious ones are in there creating too. What are the emotional patterns that keep recurring to you in love relationships? Is there a reoccurring feeling around love that you would like to integrate today? Sadness, betrayal, abandonment. Let's look at those. Let's just become aware of something that keeps recurring that we would like to feel and integrate. Mine have shown up very clearly. And when you're breathing today and they come up, what I want to ask you to do is feel them. Just allow yourself to feel them fully, unconditionally, without judgment or any need to understand what it's about. Just feel whatever is there and continue to breathe. Can we do that? All right. So now we're going to go a step further and we want to look at what feeling or feelings would you like to replace the others? Satisfaction, joy, unconditional love, fulfillment, appreciation. Just look at what is the feeling or feelings you would like to replace the ones that have been showing up. Take a breath and just go there for a moment. And now imagine yourself experiencing that feeling. Take a few breaths and just go into that space and notice, where do you feel that in your body? And continuing next level, what is your dream and vision around love in your life? And what does that look like? And I've been playing with that one. We take a few breaths and just dare to go there. Allow yourself to go beyond limitations and beliefs and feelings around what is possible. How do you see yourself loving and living in love? And just let that sink in for a minute because we're really just preparing for our breathing session. So I want to ask you now to take a few breaths, breathing in to a breath into your belly. Big breath into your heart. And I'm going to invite you to stretch your arms, open your eyes. Coming back. So for me, these awarenesses have been really revealing and also have empowered me to see ways to elevate my love experience, working with the issues on the mental and emotional to be able to gain access to the pure love that I am. So are you ready this leap year? Because it is leap year. It's full moon leap year to leap forward and dedicate the intention of true self-love and awareness in our session today. How does that sound? Are you ready for your journey into expanded self-love? We like that? Are we ready? All right. So we're going to transition into our session. It's a lot of beautiful energy. The leap year provides extra energy, balancing out numerically and giving us leaps into light and love and healing. And we have the full moon, so we can take full advantage of this beautiful global community that we're in and together with. And just go for it today and tapping into what already exists and that we can be more of and express more of.